Good morning, students. Today we will learn about comprehension. Before I start today's class, I would like to answer Srijan Shannal. Srijan, you have asked whether you can use to in when you start to write self address. So probably in that case, if you can use to or maybe to the receiver. So whatever be the place, neither in case of self address nor in case of receiver's address, nowhere you are supposed to use to. So you will definitely not use to. And I would like to request all of you to follow the format provided by us. So whatever format we teachers are trying to provide, you just follow that format and do not add anything. Means ICSE is having its own format, so we generally follow that only. So try not to use any other format. And now you all need to concentrate in grammar part, whatever I have taught so far. So those chapters only you need to concentrate, and you need to practice whatever is provided by me and whatever exercises are done yet. You need to focus on those things, and you need to practice in such a way that if I ask you any kind of questions from the rules or from the exercises, you will be able to answer. I hope you all doing the work, you all are practicing. And in case of letter format, there also it's my suggestion that you all need to know the format very well, very lucidly. So that if I ask you question on in case of format, in case of even comma full stop, there also you need to answer me correctly. I hope you all are smart enough to understand my point. Now let us focus on the comprehension part. In case of comprehension, we will be having comprehension, and there will be 20 marks allotted, right? So for this part, we will be given a passage, right? A particular passage will be given, and what we need to do is we need to read the passage very minutely. We need to read the passage carefully. So once we are done with the passage, means one, if we go through one time, then we feel like, yes, I have understood. It's nothing like that. Even if you understand, then also you need to read it twice. And if you don't understand, or if you understand little bit, then the matter, obviously you can understand, then you need to read more and more. So what you need to do is, at least you need to read it twice, and rather you need to read it until or unless or until you understand it clearly, the passage and the main points. Main points means the points the passage deals with, means the passage is what is the subject matter of the passage, as well as the question deals with, means the part the questions deals with, the questions deal with. Now what you need to do is you need to read the passage minutely or very carefully. Then you need to, next you need to read the questions. Questions you will find in B part, where there you will be finding all the questions, and you need to read the questions first. Then what you have to do is, once you are done, you have read the questions, now you have to go back to the passage, and you need to identify the area from the area which can be the answers of those questions. Okay, that means you need to read it again. Then if you can locate part of the answer or part of the passage from where the questions have been said, then you can proceed to write your answer. So this question has generally three parts. First part is vocabulary, where you will be given three words from the passage. Okay, and those three words will be in bold form in the passage itself, so it's quite easy to identify them. Now you have to identify those words in the passage also. Now you have to provide synonyms of those words. Sometime maybe if you cannot get the exact synonym of that particular word given in the question, you can use a phrase that consists of three words. Okay, but what is the most important thing is you need to follow the form or the rather the tense form or means the tense form of that particular word given in the vocabulary question. Now if the question is a verb, the question word is a verb, then your synonym and it is in present continuous tense or present indefinite or simple past, whatever be the tense form, synonym of your word should also have the same form and tense. I hope you understand. Now if the word is a noun, then your answer should also be a noun. I hope you understood. I will provide one example here to make you understand. Now next part is short questions, that will be question B. Now question B will be having five questions and it will carry 9 marks. First question will carry generally 1 mark and rest 4 questions will carry 2 marks each. Sometime it may, one may take 3 marks, that doesn't matter, but in total it will carry 9 marks. So what you have to do is that I have already explained, after reading the passage you need to read this part first. Okay, you need to read this part after reading the passage. Then comes, I will make it more clear when I will be individually discussing these things. Then comes summary or draft. Now this part is a bit different because it's not a precis writing or summary. Rather, you can consider it to be a broad question on that passage, and it should be in grid form as well as in passage form. Now what is grid? Grid means and there is also why it's a different means, their word limitation is given 50 words, in not more than 50 words, means within 50 words you have to form your draft. Now if your word is 51 or 52, there is your marks, there is negative marking, your marks will be deducted. And if it is less than, then also you will face problem. So you have to be very much careful in this particular part. Now comprehension, you may take it lightly that okay, I know everything, but it carries, means this comprehension here also 20 marks allotted. So we need to be a bit, means here also we can score very good marks if we concentrate more or if we learn all the rules properly, right? So I will discuss individually on each part. Now vocabulary, I have discussed everything. Only one thing that I need to tell you. Suppose you got a word, one word in the vocabulary part, and the word also you have located in the passage. Now what you have to do? If you cannot understand the meaning of the word, what will you do? The thing you will do is you have to find out the word in the passage and the sentence in which the word has been used. I hope you all are in class 8, means if you do not understand exact meaning of even a particular word, then also you can understand the meaning of the entire sentence. Okay, so you will have to understand the meaning of the entire sentence and you have to guess what can be the meaning of that particular word. So you will get a bit idea because you have read the passage carefully. So it's quite easy for you to understand meaning of one particular sentence, and from that particular sentence what can be the meaning of that particular word, that also you can guess. Now if you can guess that this can be the meaning, now you have to find out the synonym of that word. Now you got one synonym, now you place your word into that sentence. If the meaning remains same, then there is no chance that your word is wrong. So in this way you can do the vocabulary part. If you do not understand the exact meaning of the word, it might help you. Now what I told, you need to be careful about the form and tense of the answer word, and it should be same as the word given in the passage. Now as I told, if the word is a verb and it is in present continuous tense, like meandering, now your answer should be wandering or twisting. You cannot write wonder or twist. I hope you all understood. Now if similarly, if the question word is mentioned, Now you have to write large house or grand house like this. So you need to follow the exact form and tense of the question word. Now let us focus on the short question part that I have already discussed everything. The most important part is that the answer must be precise. Precise means it should be to the point. Yes, it should be to the point, it should be concise, it should be precise. Means you should not provide irrelevant things over there. Irrelevant details are not required. Whatever the question has demanded, try to fulfill that. And you have to find out the answer, and you, as I told you, you need to locate the location of the means answer of the question in the passage first. And you cannot exactly copy the word. You should write the answer in your own words. You generally try not to leap sentences or exact sentences from the passage. Okay, do not leap directly from the passage. Yes, you can do that if the question demands for some quotation, then in that case that is exceptional. That you all also can understand that if the question demands quotation, there you are bound to copy exactly whatever is there in the passage. But generally in question answer part, do not try to write the exact thing from the passage. Rather, if you can write it in your own words, that will be good for you. Now the different part, that is the summary writing part, I will focus. There I told you that there is negative marking and you should not exceed the word limitation. Your word limitation is 50 words, and you need to be careful that your summary must not be shorter than 48 words. Okay. So you have to be careful, and it cannot be 51 anyway. So you need to focus on this particular part. So as I told you, it's not a précis or summary. It deals with only one part of the passage, or you can consider it as a broad question. So you have to very careful, and you need to, suppose you got the question means in draft portion. Now you have to identify from which part the question has been taken. As I the process will be more or less quite same, because that is short question and you can consider nowhere it is written, but the more you practice, you will understand it's nothing but a broad question, but you have to write it in a specific manner, in a specific way. So you need to find out the answer. Then you need to, everything you cannot just jot down. There also you need to remember about the word limitation, the exact thing you cannot copy. So you have to write it in your own words. So what you have to do is, you have to think what can be the most important thing or most relevant points according to the question. Then you have to draw a grid. Now grid will be, you have to draw 10 lines, and then you will place 5 words in each. Automatically it will be 50. Now the article A and these are also words, so you have to be very careful. For each word you are bound to use one square. Now A is even a word, so you have to be careful about this. And you can use a short form like don't instead of do not. If you write do not, you have to use two square. If you write don't, you can use one square. So in this way you can carry on. Yes, and once your grid is done and you have jotted down all the relevant points, you have to provide it you will be writing it in pencil, okay, wooden pencil. Then you have to title the grid as rough draft. You can see I have written here, title this as rough draft. Okay, then it's completely done. Now if you want to include something or exclude, that also you can do. Now after that you have to write it in passage form. Okay, first you will do it in grid form. There you will draw a table. One side it will have 10 number and another side 5. So it will automatically 10 into 5, that is 50. It will automatically be 50. Now after that you need to jot down that thing freshly and in passage form, and you have to provide fair in the title fair draft on that passage. Now once you are done with the fair draft, just strike through the rough draft with only one diagonal stroke, then you are done. Now it's you need not to provide any title or justification. It was earlier there, now it's not there. So the task is quite easy for you all. You need not to provide any title or any justification to support your title. I hope you all understood. Most of the students having the problem in this particular part, that is draft. I hope you all have understood. What you have to do is you have to go through all the rules jotted down in your study material very carefully. If you do, once you do it, you will get its fruit. Believe me, once you do it minutely, you will get the fruit whenever you practice comprehension. Now some important things you need to remember. You have to use your own language as far as possible. You cannot copy exact thing from the passage. Yes, and your thing should not be written in point form. Okay, it should be rather, it means like any other answer of any other question. It should be rather a series of logically connected sentences, okay, which bring out the main idea that the question demands. And you have to use simple language. Try to use ornamentation or figure of speech. Means it might cause means the exceed of word limitation. If you are, it's better to use simple language, and that is going to provide you good marks. And unnecessary details are not required. Serve the question. Yes, whatever the question demands, try to write the answers, the relevant points, try to write to the point answers. And if suppose the passage from where it is taken, if you know the entire passage, then also you need not to provide anything extra that is not present in the passage. Even if you can understand, okay, this passage is taken from this particular short story or this particular novel or this particular article, then also if you know, if you have some extra information, then also you are not supposed to say or write anything extra that is not present in the passage. So these are the things you need to remember. And today I have discussed all these points because I thought it's necessary, it's required. And I repeat, once you go through all the rules, whatever is noted down here minutely, you will get the fruit whenever you practice comprehension. So now what, you have a task in your turn, that is you have to open, first you have to read the study material very carefully. Then you need to open the worksheet. In worksheet you will find a passage. You have to read the passage, and following all these rules you have to answer those questions. Okay, and I will discuss those particular questions in my next class. I hope you all will do this. First thing is, if you cannot do, you need to remember all these points. You need to understand them and you need to keep them within your within you. So if you cannot manage the passage today also, no problem, take your time. By next day you must keep it ready with you, and next day I will discuss all those answers as well. So today you need to spend more time on the study material part. That's why I have not done the question answer part discussion. Now again I would like to remind you, so far in grammar part, so far I have taught you need to learn those chapters very carefully. Whatever I have shared, those things you have to go through and you have to follow your textbook keep your preparation in such a way that even if I ask you whether in finite verb we will get object or not, you will be, and such type of question also you need to be keep yourself very ready. Your answer can be sometime as soon as you find a sentence, you can easily identify, yes, this sentence grammatically it's wrong. So keep your preparation, keep on preparing yourself in such a way. I hope you, and in case of formats also, and in case of book, this comprehension also, I hope you all will listen to my words carefully. Now keep on doing your work. Take very good care of yourself. Stay fit. Thank you. Have a nice day.